Hi guys, welcome back to another video. As you can probably tell, I'm back in France on the garage and all the stuff I'm wearing because it's pretty nippy outside. It's not too bad today. It's a little bit damp, but it's probably about 8 degrees. So the last few days it was like one or two, which was pretty grim to be honest, but this is all right. It's not quite Portugal, but yeah, it's all right. So today I've just got a recovery ride for this weekend. And I'm just gonna go to the boulangerie, pick up a little croissant and see how it compares to the Portuguese one, and get a little coffee as well. So yeah.
This is also the first wet ride for the Pinarello, so a bit of a sad day. But yeah, just my usual easy, like 45 minutes an hour, super easy recovery ride. And for this weekend, I've got 2 days with the team in Normandy training. So yeah, sort of, quite a big weekend planned, hopefully, and I'll be the next vlog up, which will be good.
So I've made it to the cafe and I got myself a croissant. So I've just started it. I've got about half left and started off pretty well. It's nice and it's moist. It's people are just looking at me strangely, but it's pretty moist. It's nice and like crunchy on the outside, like this bit here on the end. It's a lot more bubbly as well compared to the one in Portugal. In Portugal, it was just one big hole, but now it's like loads of little holes, like the pastry's been done properly, and it's not savoury, it's like a sweet one, so it's perfect. I mean, I can't really think of anything wrong with it, so this might actually have to be like 10 out of 10, the perfect French croissant. And this is just an example of how the Portuguese chefs make their croissants from now on, so I'm pretty happy with that. It's gone down lovely with the coffee, so yeah, gonna finish it off now. Another thing before I forget was the taste. A perfect croissant should taste like a lot of butter's been used. This one has, and most of the ones in France have, so yeah, that's another positive.
Having had slightly more time to think about the croissant during the day, as it's now the afternoon, I've had to come to the conclusion that it's only a 9 out of 10, unfortunately, due to the size, which was a little bit small compared to previous croissants. Even the one in Portugal was a few centimetres longer, which obviously the Portuguese one was rubbish, but you know, still, I would have liked a little bit bigger. And also the price of the croissant was about €1.10, which is not the cheapest croissant, but it's not the most expensive croissant, but you know, ideally maybe around that €1 mark, 90 cents would be ideal. So I'm gonna have to say 9 out of 10. But other than that, other than these two things, it was perfect.
Just bumped into Adam Lewis. I think he's got a tea, had 2 hours today, but he's zooming off now. Bloody hell. Yeah, he's zooming off. Nearly home, there's so much oil on the road. It's classic France, especially when it's wet. I just need to catch up with Adam about going into like zone four.
So I just got back about 45 minutes, just got to clean the bike now. It's looking pretty sad and dirty. First time it's got wet and dirty, so it's, yeah, sad times, but I'm gonna have it looking fresh for tomorrow. But I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed the croissant, and I'll see you in the next one.